Typically, the convertible version of a sports car is going to be slightly less sporty. It's a little more floppy, you also get a little bit more weight just due to the mechanism and the fact that you chop the roof off. But with the C63S AMG, you get one giant added benefit from chopping the roof off. You can really, really hear that glorious AMG 4.0 V8. In stock form, the C63S makes 503 horsepower and 516 pound-feet of torque. 0-60 will happen in 4 seconds flat, rear-wheel drive only. But if that's not fast enough for you, you get the Brabus 600 kit, which pushes this thing to 591 horsepower and 590 pound-feet of torque. 0-60 drops by a quarter second and has a top speed of 186 miles an hour. I can say without a doubt that a 600 horsepower rear-wheel drive C63 is going to be a ton of fun. Let's hop in the car and see what it's like. To get the power increases that the Brabus 600 kit provides, they remapped the fuel injection, the ignition timing, and increased the boost. And this whole package actually comes with a 3-year, 62,000-mile warranty, which not many aftermarket kits can claim. The Brabus 600 can also include things like an exhaust system that has valves on it that makes it go from scare children mode to sneak home really late at night, so your wife doesn't hear you mode. It's a valved exhaust. This car didn't get that, just the power increases. Some other things the Brabus 600 kit also can provide are carbon fiber splitter, diffuser, mirror caps, things like that. Owner hasn't decided on doing that yet. As of now, it's just the power increases. So I've been in C63 sedan, coupe, convertible before. This is my first time getting to actually drive a C63S convertible and with the Brabus kit, so it's just a lot more powerful. But we can talk about it from the basic standpoint. My absolute favorite part of modern AMGs in this C63S is that engine, that 4-liter twin turbo V8. Yes, the older naturally aspirated big V8s were also great, but this thing has such a great response, power, the power is addicting, and it also sounds really, really good. I think sound has to be one of my favorite parts of it too. In addition, I mean, it just, it cracks, it pops. Put the windows down a little bit. This thing sounds really good, and it's just a stock exhaust. So how does this thing compare to one of its biggest competitors, the M4? I've spent a lot of time in M4s and M3s. Honestly, this makes the M4 powertrain feel boring and basic. That straight six, it makes good power, but compared to this 4-liter V8, it sounds boring. It doesn't provide as much power or excitement. This thing is absolutely brutal. Now, this 4.0 was found in many, many Mercedes, from AMGs to even non-AMGs now. It's proliferated across the lineup. And it's really cool how much power can be gained from it in terms of calibration, changes to it. You can do downpipes, exhaust tune, and they're pushing serious power. This engine, with tweaks to it, turbocharger changes, makes 600 plus horsepower, and cars like the E63, AMG GTR level cars, the AMG 4-door, but in the smallest package, the C63 coupe, pushing out 503 horsepower, 600 horsepower is a riot. Those bigger cars, a lot of them, like the E63, has all-wheel drive to help put it down. This thing is rear-wheel drive, so it's a bit tail happy. With the C63, you get different drive modes, as with all the new modern AMGs, going from individual, comfort, sport, race. It changes the levels of aggressiveness of the shifting, the suspension. Speaking of suspension, the C63 is very firm, very, very firm. It's not the most comfortable, especially on our garbage Michigan roads. So if you're looking for a more comfortable kind of luxury coupe type of thing, this is not gonna be for you. You're gonna wanna upsize maybe to an E-Class or an S-Class coupe. But the different modes of driving, it really sharpens the handling of it, and it makes it just more of an animal, really. Talking about the styling, so when the C-Class launched with this refresh update, and then they came out with the S-Class and E-Class, I was like, wait, they're all starting to look kind of the same. This is unmistakably an AMG, though, with the more aggressive grille, the flared out kind of fenders, your quad exhaust to belt back. Now this one has been wrapped satin black. It looks evil with the Brabus badges on it. It is a convertible. I don't love soft top convertibles. I know I had a soft top convertible R8, but it wasn't my favorite thing of it. They look good with the top down, with the top up, I'm not a huge fan of the way they look. I actually personally really like the C63 sedan, the way that looks, but it looks unmistakably mean AMG and angry. They've also updated the C-Class lineup, so now the newer AMG technology. It's got the Pan America grille with like the vertical slats, which I think looks really good too. On the inside, Mercedes has been doing an excellent job. This is definitely, I think, the best in the segment. The updated Audis are really nice, but they're a little more cold feeling, more minimalistic type of. This materials, the design, the cascade of carbon fiber, your round vents, the IWC dash clock set in there, the Burmeister sound system with the metal grills. It's so, so nice. I really do love the latest Mercedes. And this is actually the pre-refresh one. The refresh one went to the newer Mercedes-Benz UX, the double screen thing, and the newer steering wheel, which is just crazy, crazy nice. But even so, as a 2018 model car, this interior is very nice. It's easy to see out of, it's spacious. The owner has a younger kid, so they put the kids in the back. It fits kids. So it's definitely a nice place to be. If we talk about value, the C63 convertible really only has the M4 convertible as a direct competitor. And I kind of already talked about what I like more about this. And the only one of the big things the M4 has that would be an advantage is you can get a manual transmission. You cannot get a C63 with a manual transmission anymore. Price-wise, you could look at something like maybe a Corvette Z06, but that is a little less practical, a little less refined. You don't get back seats in the Corvette Z06 for similar prices. You get 650 horsepower, 650 pound-feet of torque. I don't know how many people are going to be cross-shopping those. And technically, I guess a Porsche 911 would be kind of a similar space, but it's a little bit smaller and a lot more expensive. If you want like a Carrera GTS, you're going to be spending way more. C63 AMG will get you, I mean, between 80 to 100,000 when you're towards the newer end. You could put a lot of options on these things. Used, they've become pretty good values too, so it kind of stands apart from it. I think this is for somebody who still wants a big, powerful V8. They want that Mercedes brand, the badge, and a bit of the luxury and refinement. And then if you want the Brabus kit, you just want something that's completely different and unique. You want to be different from the AMGs. You like the extra power. It's very well, you know, it's a well-designed and engineered product. It's been tested. They stand behind it with a warranty. And then again, with the Brabus badges on it, people who know cars are going to be like, whoa, that's legit, because I don't think Brabus makes a single slow car. And then people who don't know cars are going to be like, what the heck is the B badge? Isn't that a Mercedes? Like, what does that even mean? I think it's cool to get a very unique look to it. And then you have the added benefit of 600 horsepower in your little rear-wheel drive AMG coupe. That is, it's a ton of fun. It is tail happy. It makes really loud, angry noises, and it's definitely put a big smile on my face getting to drive it. One downside that I definitely have to mention is going to be the transmission. It's the 7-speed wet clutch MCT that's getting a little bit old. It's not as fast as the newer 9-speeds that they find in some of the more modern AMGs. When you're going between like drive reverse, it almost takes a little bit of a lag to it. It'll rip off pretty quick shifts, but it's just not as seamless as some of the newer stuff. It's not horrible, but it's not as good as the latest cutting edge transmission technology. Again, I mentioned earlier, it rides very firm. I'm in the Sport Plus mode right now. I get to turn the suspension back into comfort, and it gets a little bit better, but it's a pretty firm vehicle. Other than that, I mean, it sounds really good. It looks mean. It's a lot of fun to drive, and the Brabus kit gives it 600 horsepower, so it's fast. Oh, that is fun. That is a lot of fun. So there we go. The Brabus 600 based off the C63S convertible. The power is definitely addicting. You get 0 to 60 in 3.8 seconds. Top speed of 186 miles an hour. That's pretty much supercar numbers. It sounds beastly. It sounds mean, angry. It is a ton of fun. It's a handful. It looks really mean. I love that the owner wrapped this thing satin black. It looks pretty cool, actually. I've gotten kind of tired of the matte black satin blacks, but on this car, it looks really menacing. If you want a convertible, you can do it. You can also apply this kit to a coupe or the sedan version of it. It's the same powertrain. This thing is really cool. It stands out in where the segment has kind of gone to either like a six-cylinder, straight six, or a V6 turbo. It still has a V8. Makes a ton of power. This is the way an AMG should feel. Hope you guys like this video. Make sure you check out the ownership video that we did with the owner, Yusuf. Thanks for watching.